And the D looking like they may blitz. They'll come out in the pistol. Now Simeon. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. Give him 13 on the pickup there. And it'll be good for Denver first down. Now a carry. It's C.J. Anderson. And he's across the 43. Extra yards to the 43. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Simeon. He goes underneath for Anderson. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and they're going to have a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So the offense needing 4 yards, it's third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Super Bowl 49 hero Malcolm Butler. And they're going to set up shop at the 20.
Super Bowl, the intercept that reverberates, the one that denied Seattle back-to-back Super Bowl titles. But he's become a very talented, good player in the league. He's not going to just be remembered for one play.
Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. They'll run again with Blunt. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
When we did DeMarcus Ware's games in Dallas, didn't we spend most of the time talking about him rushing the passer?
We did, and how about now?
Oh, boy, he's expanded his game in a big way. Really does a great job in the run game now, using his length, using his leverage to hold the point of attack and make plays as we just saw there.
The new acquisition, Martellus Bennett, the intended target, and now it's third down.
While we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore, I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. Now Brady. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Now the 4-year man out of Louisiana Tech, that's Ryan Allen, on to kick this one away. This is taken at about the 14. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And they're definitely showing blitz here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to take another shot here. He was looking for Jordan Norwood that time. And that'll bring up second down. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. A good pickup there of 22. First couple weeks of the season, Sanders started off slow, 8 catches. The last 3 weeks, though, he's had 24 catches.
And remember, he did it first with Trevor Siemian. So he and Siemian got in sync, and it continued on with Paxton Lynch this last week. They didn't win the game, okay? Atlanta beat them. But Emmanuel Sanders is in a pretty good groove right now, and I expect that to continue.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll look to throw now on first down. Norwood's got it, complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They'll give him a yard on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. And ready now for second and 9.
Here we go now.
Now Siemian. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're pretty early in this contest, and with one interception already thrown, when that ball was tipped in the air, I think he had to be wondering, could this be a second one, and was already battling in his mind how to handle it. Fortunately, that ball fell incomplete, and now he gets a chance to atone for what could have been a big error.
Offense in a little bit of a bind here. 9 yards to go on third down. To throw again, and he fires one that's intercepted, picked off by Logan Ryan. And look out, I think he's gonna go, and he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Patriot defense has a touchdown. They were in the dime. They had 6 defensive backs there, so go ahead and throw it. He threw it, and it hurt it.
It's almost thrown into a blanket of coverage, isn't it? You talk about the best defenders you have are the defensive backs. 6 of them on the field, you're almost asking for trouble, and that's exactly what they ran into. Ended up throwing a pick 6.
Yeah, 6 defenders and 6 points. Now Steven Goskowski on for the extra point. Play clock winding down. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. They'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. Here's Anderson as they begin this series on the ground. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. Anderson against the Falcons, 41 yards on 11 carries. And, you know, you total up the numbers, 84 carries this year, 3.5 per.
And what they're used to getting from C.J. Anderson is 3.5 yards per carry. That part, this is kind of normal, but they're also used to getting that big home run shot from it. All right, you remember against New England in 2015, he finished that game in the snow with a big jaunt. They need more of that, him being able to get to the third level into the secondary.
Simeon. Green's got it over the middle. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that'll lead here to a third down. Looking to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Taking it about the 16. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in each. Your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Bradley Roby, the quarterback, there to make the stop. Seven yards remaining here on third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The New England defense gearing up to take the field. Their stay on the field last time was short-lived with a 3-and-out. See if they can get some more of that.
And ordinarily, you want to be on the field playing, right? But 3-and-out, that's almost gold to a defense. Get to the bench, get some rest, turn the ball over to your offense.
We'll see what they can do here. See if they can force another 3-and-out. They start the drive with Anderson. And he's brought down. 12 yards on the pickup, and it'll be first down Denver.
C.J. Anderson may not be a Pro Bowl runner, but he knows how to run big in big games.
Yeah, he sort of sealed the Super Bowl for them in the fourth quarter. Big game against the Patriots last year on a Monday night, but only 720 yards all told in 2015. They'll look to throw here. And Sanders has got it complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It'll be a gain of 9. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
that was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver, and it's third and short.
Well, that play certainly took a long time, and that's why a lot of coaches in training camp use a whistle or a horn at about 3 seconds because they want the ball in the hands of the quarterback. They want the play to develop quickly and get the ball downfield. This one had to go over 5 seconds holding on to the football, and then he ends up getting hit and have an incompletion.
He'll look to throw, and it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Back alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Bronco football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. And some extras coming up on the line here, ready for the blitz. To throw now on first down. Sanders has it over the middle, and he's brought down after a good gain. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Fresh set of downs here. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now Simeon. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. And all the way home for a Bronco score. Emmanuel Sanders, 33 yards. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Encroachment defense.
Another extra point opportunity here. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And now out come the Patriots. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Chris Hogan, 75 yards. And the Patriots are able to strike quickly for 6. And that is how you retaliate after getting scored on one play, big pass downfield, and you hit the end zone.
Almost feels like two boxers just throwing haymakers at each other, doesn't it? One connects with a big one, the other comes right back. Okay, I'll show you. And they attacked right back on the first play of the drive and hit them big.
And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Hey. That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field. Punch it in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
In the backfield is Anderson. Simeon. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and forced an incompletion.
So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on 3rd and 10. They're going to look to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and that just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Taken in at the 22. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Going deep here for Edelman. This is caught inside the 15. Brady and Edelman hook up for a big one. 54 yards. The former 7th-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Brady now on 1st down. That's caught at the 2. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll make it 2nd and goal. Brady to throw on 2nd down. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman from a yard out. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
As more and more up-tempo football creeps into the NFL game, some coaches don't think time of possession matters anymore. I believe we found one of them.
The point after try for Gostkowski. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Encroachment defense.
Now another shot here at the PAT. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And coming out now, the Broncos. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play. First level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position end up making the tackle. And oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
They come up with an offset eye. On 2nd down, Anderson. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Here comes the D swarming to the line. First down. Here's the run with Anderson. They find some open field here. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Every now and then when we see a really good run, we really tend to focus on what other people did in order for that run to happen. What the offensive line did, what the receivers did to help. Sometimes running back's pretty good too. And on that play, he picked up a lot of good yardage and made it happen with great effort.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Green with a catch left side. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here. Now Anderson. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. Play fake here on 1st down. And he'll go out of bounds down inside the 15-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They'll set up a throw. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away. But it does get away, and it's 2nd down.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off 2 passes. That would have been the 3rd in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
So the incomplete pass brings up 2nd down.
Here we go.
He'll look to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So that is three interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but yeah, let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
I'm actually surprised they didn't get out of that play. I didn't see anyone pressing the line of scrimmage for the defense.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Brady. And he fires one, but incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and that'll bring up a fourth down. Here's Ryan Allen now as he's on to punt for New England. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taking it about the 36. So a change of possession here on the punt. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50. First and 10. The D for the Pats. The Patriots heading back onto the field now. And the interception the last time. Their third takeaway of the game, Charles.
They're just flocking to the football so well. And not only are they doing that, they're making big-time plays and taking it away from them. Big hits, big plays. They're looking very good in this ballgame.
You said flocking, flying to the football. Coaches always use that, don't they?
They really do. It's almost as it goes back to the old, when they click off the frame at the end of a play, they want to see all 11 defensive guys in that picture.
In the backfield is Anderson. Now Simeon. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
So the Patriots coming out now. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. You know, Gronk, the cover boy, he looked like he had a little bit of a healthier hamstring with Tom Brady back under center in week 5.
And when Tom Brady's back under center, your hamstring does feel better. You want to be on the field with Tom Brady, and I know both of them excited to be on the field together. How about Gronk? 5 catches, 109 yards. He's back and in a big way.
You get him going with Bennett? Oh, boy.
Look out, folks. I saw Von Miller in college at Texas A&M, and all I kept hearing about was his speed off the edge to the quarterback. But what impressed me, his balance and his ability to take on blocks and be a force in the run game, as we just saw there.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
They give it to Anderson. And nowhere really to go there. He'll They'll take this up just shy of midfield. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Defense showing blitz. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Simeon. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Virgil Green is tied in, the intended receiver. And it's third down. So a third and eight. Now back to throw. And now here's another interception. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Julian Edelman, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
Nice, nice, sweetheart. 20, by 20.
Reload.
6 yards, check 6 yards.
Hey, 66.
Tighten up.
20.
Switch.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. So as they take it over, we step aside. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half.
And the Broncos go to a nickel set on third down.
Yeah, they've got an extra DB out there. To throw is Brady. Going for the deep ball. Oh, wide open, complete. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And they extend their lead, a little added cushion into the lockers. What a way to finish.
Tremendous way. That's momentum that they carry in with them. Can they convert it and bring it back out to start the third quarter?
Gostkowski for the point after. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley.
Well, that came a little abruptly here. Still working on my Apple up in the booth. Hang on here. Let me spit this out. And we can get to the third quarter now. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taken about 7 yards deep, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
The drive starts with a handoff to Blum, and he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
Here's Bull, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and we'll still get the first down. They love being physical.
Blunt, the lone running back. And he'll get it up the middle. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Partner, I think the easy thing now would be to just abandon the run and start throwing the football at all costs. But I've been in so many games where it doesn't work running the ball, doesn't work running the ball, and then something pops, and now you get something going. I'm not so sure to just abandon your game plan this early in the second half.
Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 13. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is
not just a big man, a huge man.
Big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Yeah, well, that's for sure. And you know what, else? I didn't want to challenge him at dinner either.
He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. It's a gain of five, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it'll be 1st and 10 Broncos from deep in their own territory. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
Emmanuel Sanders, and all the way home for a Broncos score. Emmanuel Sanders, 91 yards, and the Broncos cut into that lead. Well, they were back in the shadows of their own goalpost, and that flipped quickly.
So much for playing it safe. I mean, the conservative, easy call, run the football, take care of it, create some space, pump the ball away, but no, let's throw it. And sometimes a defense's aggressiveness is used against them because when you've got people backed up, your natural inclination is to try and really force them back, and sometimes they get burned that way.
And they got burned there. McManus now for the extra point. It's up and good, and it's now 28-14. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Now the Broncos Rose heading back out onto the field. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
And that type of effort just continues to carry over, because once you get it done once, you feel like you can do it again and again. It's no guarantee, but you got to like the confidence that they take back out into the field.
Now, will they keep that confidence? Time to find out. They go play action here on first down. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it second and short. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen, but everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Really strong, effective run there out of a power set or a heavy set. Three tight ends in the game, and that's tough for a defensive coordinator. They want to spot that lineup coming into the game early so they can get the proper defensive personnel on the field. That's why the coordinator is relying on some of the assistants to tell him what offensive personnel is hitting the field so he can adjust accordingly. They weren't able to stop him on that run.
That was close to a big play, and just a little bit too far that he was led. He caught it but couldn't stay in bounds, Charles.
Yeah, I'm not very good at these sort of things, but I have to believe the farther you are downfield, the less your margin for error in throwing the ball, correct?
Yep.
Yeah, so they gave it a good effort there. Really tried, just couldn't complete it.
A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
We just saw what a lot of teams call a heavy set. Three tight ends in the game. That signifies they want to run the football. Yeah, occasionally they'll play action and throw it, but most of the time, those guys on the field means strength, power, run the ball behind them. And now what a lot of teams are doing is they're taking an extra.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off.
Brandon, normally when you hear about guys making two interceptions in the game, you're thinking must be a free safety, maybe a corner. How about getting two picks out of one of your linebackers? Again, he's just in the right place at the right time. That's another great play to come away with the football.
And Denver getting set to take the field. Last time they... out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Green with a catch left side. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Handoff comes to Anderson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A nice run there, 9 yards. And it'll be second down.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him. They got a completion there, but that's clearly an example of one side happy, the other side not very happy. Defense, very, hey, take 1 or 2 yards. We're good with that. Offense, you've got to expect to get more on a passing play.
Watch left. They pitch it out to Anderson, and he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. And they're going to speed things up here.
Let's go.
Looking to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds.
Now, coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Thomas, the lone receiver, left. Now Simeon. And that is incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, now fourth down. So on fourth down, on comes Brandon McManus and the field goal unit for the Broncos. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And McManus able to put it through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. Maybe an anxious moment or two when the ball was on its way, but he does find a way to curl it in.
Oh, yeah, that one definitely hugged the left upright, but he got it to go.
Back out for another drive comes LeGarrette Blount. And after a sluggish start, he's really bounced back. The numbers bear that out.
And you're a baseball guy, partner. How many at-bats over the course of a baseball season?
Oh, boy, four in the game. 162.
350 or so, right? Sometimes it takes a while for a guy to get going. That's my point. It's not the first few carries. You don't worry about that. As they go along, get that guy lathered up, get those blocking assignments down. Those two-yard gains turn into bigger gains as the game moves along.
Trying to shake off the intercept for Julian Edelman that time. A lot of big buzz in the league continues to be circling around Dallas in that quarterback spot. Tony Romo may be coming back in a few weeks, but with Dak playing this well, there's a decision to be made.
And it's been a long time since the starter getting hurt automatically got his job back when healthy. You go back to how Tom Brady got his job, and they decided to stay with him and end up winning a Super Bowl. I think since about that time, the rules have been different, so it's going to be interesting to see how Dallas handles that. You ever notice that when Tom Brady does get hit and drop to the ground, there's some guys back to him pretty quickly to check on his health, aren't there?
That's exactly right. For as much as he throws, doesn't take a lot of square shots, but took one there.
He's really smart in the pocket, isn't he? Even out of the pocket, he understands where the pressure is coming from. He senses people. You're exactly right. Doesn't take too many direct ones, but that one had to hurt.
Now Brady, over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Throughout his career, Tom Brady has made a living with the quick pass, hasn't he? How about that one? A little slant inside, and I think his arm's gotten stronger throughout his career, too.
Yeah. And you can just see one of many examples of why he's made more trips to the Super Bowl than any other quarterback.
Footwork, intelligence, competitiveness, that's Tom Brady in a nutshell.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They come up in an offset eye. Brady gives now to Blount. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Brady to throw on second down. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Aqib Talib.
When we talk about Aqib Talib, technique is not the word that comes to mind, but don't worry about that. This guy anticipates as well as anyone in the league, and he did just that, picking off another pass.
Simeon. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
Sometimes it looks pretty simple, batting the ball away, but oftentimes there's some pretty good teaching and practice that goes into it. Being able to get to the receiver, not interfere, and get his hands through the football and knock it away.
Here we go now. Boom, land it. Gone, gone. Gone, gone. Back to the end, Philly. Here we go.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He's going to launch this thing. This is caught at the 20. Back now in Foxborough. It's the Broncos trailing, but they do have possession of the football as we begin quarter number four. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Zone now. They'll look to throw. This will be caught inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They'll give him 8 on the play, and it's a second down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Another tote here for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Anderson. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It's an 8 yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll run for it with Anderson. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. C.J. Anderson taking it in. And the Broncos draw a bit closer. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
So now a big play here as the Broncos will line up to go for 2. They'll try and throw for it. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points that gets them back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the 2-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a 3-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a 2-point conversion, and now they're only down 3 and feeling great about themselves.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Here comes Tom Brady and the Patriot offense back onto the field. And the stats on the screen tell the story. A great start. This defense, they've made some good adjustments, though. He's fallen off since.
Have to like what they did at the half, but you also have to like the fact that they hung in there. Despite the fact they had a tough first half, he was locked in, right? Rocking and rolling. They came out, made their adjustments, got their confidence back. Now they're causing them all sorts of trouble.
They start on the ground here with Blunt. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. So they go out of the gun, try to delay it on the draw, but nothing there.
Yeah, good play by the defense there. They sniffed it out and made sure there were no gaps for him to run. If you're the offense, though, you have to think to yourself, maybe I go play action down the road.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Now Brady, right side, that's complete to Gronkowski. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Now a play fake here on first down. Surveying the field. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. And on second and 10 now. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. They fake the handoff. Now Brady looking deep downfield. Oh, what a catch by Edelman. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Julian Edelman, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Extra point try for Gostkowski. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Call it a gain of 5, and it'll make it a second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. From the pistol, they run with Anderson. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll run it. Here's Anderson. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. And no, it's incomplete. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough. And a great spot to start this drive from here. They come up in an offset eye. Now Blunt. Oh, no, he lost the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Brady to throw on second down. This is caught. Gronkowski. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Rob Gronkowski, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
And that's just another in a long line of passing touchdowns for him today. To say that he's been on fire would definitely be an understatement.
The point after try for Gostkowski. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And let's shift now to talking about the Patriots' defense. And they had a great fourth down stop last time that set their offense up. Great offense able to score. So offense probably over there saying, hey, do that again.
Exactly what they're saying. That's working together. That's being in tandem right there. Stop them on defense. Offense gets great field position, rolls in and puts points on the board. I think you're exactly right. Can you do it for us one more time? We'll take it.
And they'll try and do it again. And the D looking like they may blitz. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Simeon. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. They go play action here on first down. Looking for Sanders here on the deep ball.
Brandon, what we just saw there is something we hear from coaches throughout the league. How are you going to defend what they call the moment of truth ball, meaning a 50-50, the ball's in the air, defenders there, receivers there, who's going to make a play on the football? And in this case, the defensive guys actually got it done and knocked it away.
Screen play, Anderson. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. And now a first down following that long gain. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That is caught at the 7. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. A good catch there and a first down for the offense.
Excellent awareness by the receiver to know where the first down marker was.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll run. Anderson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And the challenge pays dividends. The ref overturns the play.
Everyone gets a bonus on this one, Brandon. The coach upstairs who says signaled down and said challenge it, and the head coach for pulling the red flag.
And they're definitely showing blitz here. Now Simeon. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Now back to throw. That's caught at the 3.
Holding offense.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down.
Here we go now. Green 39.
No. Check. Patriots.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And this is incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And the Patriots defense is going to take over on down. And that time they went with a fade on fourth and goal. Did not work out.
Now, how do you feel about that type of a call? Because I've been with you long enough. I don't think the fade route in that situation is one of your favorites.
I just think you're putting yourself into a corner. You don't have any margin for error, right?
I agree with you totally. You tend to run out of real estate. You've got to make sure you run that route so well that you're allowed to fade and catch the football and come down in bounds. I think that's one of the reasons we've seen the fade stop come into play so well, because now it's a little bit more of an easy throw.
So second and 10 here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Brady. No, he doesn't have it. Maybe some alligator arms there going over the middle. Third down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. They'll run it here. This is James White. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain, and it leaves them looking at a fourth down. Here's Ryan Allen now. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. No return, but it goes down as just a punt of 31 yards. And we have reached the 2-minute warning. The Bronco offense now set to come back out onto the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And all the way home for a Bronco score. Demaryius Thomas, 57 yards. And the Broncos get a bit closer.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a 2-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a 2-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this is secured by the Patriots. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Getting down to the end here, they have a 2-score lead. Barely, but it's a 2-score lead, so that probably makes you as a coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or some kind of wild double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything does go haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you?
I'm just waiting for that day where we actually see something like that in this situation.
We'll see what happens here. And he can't quite bring it in. Might have heard footsteps there across the middle. Second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. in the end zone a big time drop.
Brady gonna throw here, letting one go deep for the end zone. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. He had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. Oh, no, he lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Well, I'm guessing that on the sidelines, there might be a few words said about that mistake there, but I don't think it's going to hurt them in the long run. They're still going to get out of here with a win.
Yeah, they got the two-score cushion, but you know what coaches say, Charles? Finish strong.
Finish the game out the way it's supposed to be played. In fact, coaches might be secretly happy. Gives them a chance to do a little extra coaching next week.
Yeah, making their way back out there now, the Patriots defense. They're just looking for one final stop here, put a capper on this affair.
Get this game over with. That's all
that
we're
the
talking
message?
About. It's that simple. Finish this thing off, and let's get to the locker room and celebrate.
Celebration, that's what they're hoping to do soon, but still a little work to do. And some room to maneuver. The 30. And all the way home for a Broncos score. C.J. Anderson, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Broncos have cut it to within a score.
And they put it in the end zone, which was job one. Now they have to convert, and then it's decision time, isn't it?
Yeah, so this is what all teams go through. You look at the clock, you're inside 2 minutes, look at your timeouts, make that onside kick decision.
Yeah, how do you feel about your defense, where you are in terms of the scoreboard and the time left on the clock? As you noted, so many things to go through.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They'll look to throw, and they're going to get the two. It's caught, and the lead is cut to two here in the fourth. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
So with just over a minute to play, this becomes a make-or-break onside kick. And this is secured by the Patriots. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that when they needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it. But even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. They have the football. They're looking good, but the lead is just two. So any mistake in a field goal can beat you. They got to be careful.
And that's where it gets difficult, because you don't want that to leak into your thinking. You want to play like, hey, we've got the advantage. We can close this out. Don't play from fear, and they can win this game.
See if they can play fear-free. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Big sack on second down. Now the offense needs to convert here on third. They come up in an offset eye. Back to throw. Brady goes underneath here to White. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Brady. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. So the offense has it, first and 10. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now a play fake. Now hang on here, timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Brady going to look to throw, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Personal foul, face mask, defense. That penalty is declined.
And here comes play number six on this drive. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Brady, he's going to go for a big play downfield. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on fourth. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Broncos will take over on downs. One final shot. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up.